Hello, 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 hello. Hello and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. And this is a quick tutorial on something that has been perplexing a lot of people. And I've come up with a simple way of demonstrating it and getting it to work. And it is the custom Airtight door. A lot of people who have this game on PC and on Xbox have tried to create airtight doors, and I've been the same, but I've finally worked out what I was doing wrong, and there's a few rules for airtightness, and I wanted to go over at least one of them, just using a simple build for an airtight room, and all you'll need are two merge blocks, obviously the build itself, some way to control it, and let me show you the whole thing in action. See, air is flooding into that room, and that room is now airtight. How is it done? What's the secret? Well, if you've tried to make an airtight room using rotors or hinges, you've probably encountered that message that pops up when you sit inside a control seat, your merge blocks turn yellow and refuse to lock, as it says, basically, there's an error. What you need to make an airtight room, apart from a door made just of simple armour blocks attached to a hinge, is a second hinge. If I just pop out this block here, and this block here, 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 and here, you will see that there are two hinges. This hinge is set here with another hinge on top of it. So if I go to my little control seat and pop open my hinges, this is our hinge that is currently locked. As you can see, it has an upper limit of 90 and so on, and a lower limit of minus 90. But the one we're looking at is the door hinge. That's at 2 degrees. Now, its lower limit is minus 88, so that it goes flat to the floor rather than minus 90, because it keeps on trying to move through the floor. And its upper limit is 2. 0 is a bit too close, or rather a bit too far away. 2 is about right. You may have to adjust this yourself if you try and build it. But the magic is that second hinge, or the first hinge and the second hinge. That's locked off. That one is what we use to control the door. That is basically airtight, because our door is two subgrids away from the main grid, or the main grid is two subgrids away from our door. And the way that the airtightness works in Space Engineers is that it also looks at the facing of the blocks. So you may have built something in the past with windows like this and wondered why, when you've tried to see your ship, things don't work. why isn't it airtight? Well, it has to do with knowing which blocks are airtight and which aren't. And the best way to do that is to build yourself an actual airtight room. Seal yourself into it. Pop the edge block on. There we go. Have air. So, our airtight room. These windows are airtight. But block-wise, one of the best ways to do it is to cut a hole in the wall like this and then work out what block is airtight. So that, in of itself, is airtight. Because the face of that block is blocking the passage of air. But if I do this, you can also see the face is blocking the air. Obviously, that's not going to be airtight. What about it like this? Yep, that's airtight. Airtight. And of course, that's airtight. And you can go through your various blocks like this, troubleshooting to see which ones are airtight and which ones aren't. Obviously, windows like this that are designed to allow air are not airtight. If you're wondering if any of the new armour panels that came with our recent update are airtight, the answer is yes. Glass door blocks. Like this. Airtight. This one. Not airtight. Not airtight. Not airtight. Not airtight. Doors airtight. Certain components and things like that won't be airtight. You can guarantee that certain things like O2 generators are airtight. You can see there are no gaps. And so you can work through your blocks to work out airtightness, or you can look online. There is a list of airtight blocks. I don't know if it's still updated or not. I'll leave that in the description as per usual, but this is definitely airtight, as you can see. All we need to do, turn that off. That will vent the oxygen through the gaps in the door and allow us to open the door. So to repeat, one merge block inside this box, like so, works well. Another atop the door itself just needs to fit the space doesn't have to be bigger than. You can make it bigger than. You could pretty this whole thing up if you want. But remember, if you're messing around with merge blocks, there is something that can happen. And it can weld your door to your main grid if you start putting blocks on the outside and they connect in some way. So I always prefer with these doors, if I'm going to use them, to try and build anything like this now on the outer side. But as long as you make a save before you trigger your merge block, you should be fine. You can always work out what's merged, what's not. So just let's see in terms of blocks what we can do. When you're adding stuff to your door as well, you'll notice now that that merge block connected it. So we need to delete that, and then our door will come flying open as clang takes hold. So the best way to do it, so if you're going to mess around with your door, make sure it's not connected up like this, and just pop your blocks on, aim at the actual grid itself, that's the door. Not the grid below it, because that will attach it to the grid at the bottom there. When in doubt, and always aim at this part of the grid. All's gone well. So far, our airtight room. Yeah. Door. As you can see, that's the issue. What the merge block has done is the merge block has attached this entire thing to our grid. This is why I prefer to build with the simplest shape going. Otherwise, have that problem. There we go. Fortunately, you just need to delete the offending blocks. works again. So you have to be very careful when you put blocks attached when you're building a door like this. You don't really want anything that can be merged permanently like that. And then, as I showed you at the start of this, that is an airtight door. That is an airtight room. And there you go. This will be up on YouTube fairly shortly, as long as it takes me to upload it. But there it is. A short-ish tutorial explaining why you need to keep one of these doors two subgrids apart, aka the best way to do it, two hinges, one locked in place, the other as the door hinge, placed on either a switch or a control panel, allowing you to create an airtight seal on any size hangar door that you want. Hopefully that's been of some use to you. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. Hopefully you've got an idea now of what it takes to build one of these style hangar doors. There we go. There we go. I'll say, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Please drop by the community tab if you've got any builds or you've got any ideas of a tutorial you'd like to see. One thing I cannot cover are scripts, scripting, and anything to do with dedicated servers. I don't go onto dedicated servers. I don't do much multiplayer on Space Engineers. I tend to play solo because of my time as an RPG and fiction author takes up a lot more. And I don't really want to join a server and commit to anything when I don't get all that much time to do anything like this. And when I am on Space Engineers, it's to do a tutorial video. Anyway, bye for now.